Bambi. Who killed Bambi?
Hiya.
Into Grandpa and Grandma's for the night. So, we're gonna get to our morning housework. It's Matt's laundry day, and then we're gonna head out to poop.
La, 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 la.
No, don't put your fingers in there.
La, 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 la.
No. Say you should hear it. Oh, I'm happy to make time for your feelings, but you have to admit I already do. Let's just break it down to you and me uptown, dancing all around till the disco ball pops. But I have to be me, and everyone can see your anger is misplaced, and I'm gonna tell you. Don't hate me 'cause I get attention. Don't turn me into what I'm not. I have to be me 24/7, and I ain't never gonna stop. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Oh, no, no, no. No, oh, oh, oh. And I ain't never gonna stop. Come on. Listen to me. I've tried so many times to tell you this is as good as I can be. Why isn't it enough to be faithful and also be the hit of the party? Let's just break it down to you and me uptown, dancing all around till the disco ball pops. But I have to be me, and everyone can see your anger is.
I stand up and start walking when my leg's asleep. I just, my leg won't stop walking me.
I woke up once with a foot asleep, and guess what? I got off my bed, and all of a sudden I fall over.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey.
She's filming! I hit the button!
Feels nice.
What feels nice?
My foot when it falls asleep.
So you like your legs to fall asleep?
I handed you a fake cake, and you were like, oh, thank you. And then it had a punching bag, and it punched you.
Are you guys going to Grandma's? Y'all, don't forget your bug.
Oh, hey, go. I gotta show you something I do. Pretty.
No, Mom, turn it off, turn it off.
I know what he's gonna show you guys. He made a rocket ship.
There you go.
Let me see your rocket ship drawing.
It's a beautiful rocket ship.
Those circles are its wings.
I have no words. It's a beautiful rocket ship.
Yeah, right.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Have fun with Grandma.
Ow.
What are you doing?
I fell over. My bag's heavy.
Have fun.
I stuffed a lot of toys.
Hi, Poot. Did you take a nap?
I pet him and he like fell asleep. I was like this.
Hi, Ree.
Bye, Bobby.
Bye, baby. What are you climbing up front?
My legs hurt.
Look at you in a hurry.
I'm never.
You're like, let me up front. So I am headed into Hy-Vee, and we were hoping Charlie was working, but she's not working, and I'm going to get some coffee creamer because I'm out. My kids got into it and put it in their milk. Mm-hmm. And I haven't had a cup of coffee in days, so I'm headed in. I'm in the line, and if you saw, I know I was time-lapsing, but it took a minute to get through the line, and the lady in front of me was talking to the cashier, and she's like, they were talking about how she was from Illinois, and she was scanning the alcohol through for the lady, and she's like, I don't know how they got on the subject of driving. I don't know if it was because she was scanning the alcohol through or what, but she's like, yeah, sorry, do you have to be in driver's ed or something now? And she's like, yeah, because I've gone through all these counties in Illinois. She's like, I've been through at least 12 counties in Illinois. And she's like, well, what are you doing in Iowa? She's like, well, because they sent me here because I'm in the witness protection program, she says. I don't know what they were talking about, but those two, I wish I'd had the camera out. They were cracking me up. And she's like, what'd you do that you had to go in the witness protection program?
Out at night, the days are much too bright. Only come out at night. Hey, don't make me put on some Sex Pistols. Who killed Bambi?
Yeah, I'm gonna link that video.
Who killed Bambi? Who killed Bambi?
It's my life. This is my life.
You're just jealous because you don't have the music.
Oh!
No, I do.
Snap!
Oh, okay. I love Santana, Journey, and the Eagles. Oh, no.
No.
I love.
Can't even. You
I
cannot.
Love Violent Femmes, The Misfits, yeah. Sex Pistols, Smashing yeah, Pumpkins.
I like some Smashing Pumpkins.
The Doors.
But.
Bob
Smash.
Dylan.
Oh my God, no.
Bob Dylan.
No.
Yeah, now you know my secret. I don't like Bob
she
Dylan.
She once threw a Bob Dylan CD out the window.
I did. I couldn't handle it anymore. He kept playing it and playing it and playing it. It was like a screwdriver through my head.
I wish I would have been there for that because that would have been hilarious.
And don't get me wrong. I think he's a great songwriter. I just want somebody else to sing the songs.
I can't see it.
Wow.
Sorry, Bob Dylan. Love your music. Just not your voice. All right, guys. So I was just actually sitting down watching. First of all, backstory. I'm going to tell you, I have been having trouble with my camera all day. It's not the camera itself. I still don't have my video even uploaded to YouTube because I'm trying to get a sweatshirt. It's cold today, and I don't really want to turn on the heater in my writing room because it's not that cold. I just need something on, but I'm cold-blooded. Like, I can't handle the cold at all. Anyway, I was having trouble with the system that goes into my computer. I'm having a hard time explaining this because I don't understand it completely, which is probably why I was having so much trouble. There's a wash rag in my hoodie. Tell it just came out of the laundry. Anyway, I don't understand the system really well, But my camera takes, it has like its own import system, and it formats, it formats everything into the correct format to go onto YouTube, stuff like that, and it's like really ease of use. Well, all of a sudden it just like disappeared out of the computer and my camera wouldn't upload. And then when it did, it was like glitching and not wanting to upload to YouTube. So anyway, long story short, I was having trouble and couldn't get anything uploaded today. So I was watching videos of a fellow YouTuber, actually a couple of them, but I watched John Haggerty's video today, and it had popped up in my suggested videos, and it was, what? You want to be on the camera? You want to be on the camera? Say hi, everybody. It popped up in my suggested videos, and it was like five secrets that YouTubers won't tell you or something, and I wanted to kind of give him a shout out and say it was an awesome video. I mean, I know I left the comment and told him that, but it really was. Like, he was talking about stuff that I feel really strong about on there. What? Oh, my goodness, you're so noisy. What? Are you being a diva? Look at you, boy. You want to play. You just want to play. You're such a stinker. He's a stinker. Anyway, it's stuff that I really feel strongly about, and he was talking about it on there. And I know that it's stuff that I've struggled with as a YouTuber, and I know that some of my fellow YouTubers have struggled with. You put the content out and you create it, and you know, I put it out there. My goodness, would you go downstairs and just get into all kinds of mischief? What? What? He's so crazy. He keeps biting my legs and stuff. What do you want? Come on. Out, out. Yeah, we're gonna lock you out right now. Go down by tap. I don't know what's going on with him. He gets crazy. Anyway, but he was talking about, you know, putting the videos out there, and he's still barking outside the door. Listen to him. He's mad because I locked him out of my room. He's scratching at the door. What a stink pot. Okay, let's see if I can get this out now. Anyway, he was talking about these videos and, you know, how you put them out there, and of course you want people to watch them. You hope that people will watch them, but you know, not getting down about subscriber counts, stuff like that, that doing this because you really love to do it. And I tell you what, it took me, I started my channel back in November of 2015. I think I actually opened the channel up, something like that. I know I posted my first video in November. I don't know when I actually opened the channel up, but I opened it up with the intent of maybe I would post some stuff on there. Hadn't really thought about it. And then one day, and I know I've talked about this before, Aspen was playing with a thing of Miracle Whip, and it's on my Facebook. And this video was so funny. Like, he just did not, he was so little. He must have been 18 months old, I think. And he was just so funny. He didn't want to give up this thing of Miracle Whip, and he was like so butt hurt that I was going to take this Miracle Whip from him. He was hugging it up to his chest. He was, no. And it was just funny and it was cute. And I put it out on Facebook and I was like, you know, I wish there was a better place that I could compile these funny memories. And so I decided to open up our YouTube channel. And I started doing it as a hobby. I put just a few short, small videos on there. The kids talking about getting a new puppy, you know, or a video about getting a new puppy, and the kids talking about getting a new puppy and how our one puppy had died, and they were talking about doggy heaven. And if you look back, it's in our earliest videos. Those are our first few videos. I didn't know how to film at all. We had the little black bars on the side, and we had that for a long time. And it wasn't until a fellow YouTuber actually said, hey, if you flip your phone to the side, those will go away. Because I thought to myself, well, I know lots of people film on their phone, but I couldn't figure out the answer of how to get rid of these black bars on the side. And I had a fellow YouTuber get on there and leave a comment telling me how to get rid of it. And that was my first real interaction, I think, with a fellow YouTuber, like, giving me really good advice just for no reason other than they were watching the video and thought, hey, I can help you make this better. And it was just awesome. It was like the beginning of forming a community. And You know, that's what John Haggerty was talking about in his video, is he was talking about, you know, finding friends. And I have. I found a group of vlogging friends, and I found people that I watch. There's people I Snapchat with now. I found a really great, awesome, supportive community. And he was talking about that in his video today. And you really do. You find friends. You find people that are like extended family, you know, on all different sorts of social media sites, whether it's Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Tashellen 3, I met her through Instagram. I've met tons of my YouTube friends through Twitter, which, you know, for a long time, I didn't use Twitter. I had the accounts, but I didn't really use them other than to post videos. I didn't even know how to use Twitter at all. I didn't understand what the purpose of it was. And then I started watching video influencers, and now I'm in the writing room. I came down to get the vlog ready to go. But anyway, they were talking about, you know, just like, it's social. So you know, you go on there and you talk to people and get to know them. And when I started doing that on Twitter, I actually ended up meeting a lot of really cool people that I hadn't known before. So I wanted to give a shout out because I thought his video was really, just really on point today and something I really believe in, and that's keep going because you love doing it. Keep making those videos. Keep creating your content because it's something that you love to do. You know, subscribers, stuff like that, they're always going to fluctuate. That stuff's going to happen, you know. Somebody might love what you're doing and then might decide they don't. And that's okay too, as long as you love what you're doing. So shout out to John Haggerty and his channel, and I will try to remember to link it below. I'm so bad about that, but my subscriptions are open so you can see who I subscribe to, and he is in there. So if I do forget, check out my subscriptions if you don't know who the channel is, and you can find him there. He's got some great content, and I just wanted to give a shout out to a really awesome video. It is that time of night again. Where are we going?
Upstairs, a monkey jet.
Upstairs to read monkeys jumping on the bed.
Jumping on the bed.
Jumping on the bed. Yes, he is in love with this book right now, so we are going to read it again tonight, aren't we?
Mommy,
we're going to go. All right, so I am in the laundry room yet again. It's later than usual, and I need to get some items posted on Poshmark. I need to get some writing done. I also need to get this laundry finished, so I'm not off track with this because I am so close, you guys. So close. That's Skylur playing his game in the background. If you heard the banging, he's so loud when he plays. But I'm so close to getting this done, like getting all this laundry caught up. I can't tell you how many loads I've done in the last couple of weeks. But I'm coming to the end of this journey, and I cannot wait to find out where it's going to take me. I know it sounds stupid because it's laundry, but really, this has been like an ongoing battle for years. So, yeah, I'm excited about it. I know it sounds stupid, but I'm excited. I am. So I'm waiting to see, is it going to be one load a day, two loads a day I need to go to keep it up? Anyway. Just finishing up one more load, I think, of Matt, so it's going to be a little later laundry night tonight than usual. But I've had some stuff going on. I mean, just some stuff, not in the house. I mean, everything here is going relatively well. Things are falling into place. We're still making adjustments, you know, when it comes to the medication and on our autism journey as autism parents. You know, trying to make adjustments, see what's behavior and what's, you know, what's something that can't be helped. And so we're still learning that because this is just a change and it's new. But it's starting to come together a little better. Things are settling down that way. But there's just been some things in like my external family life that have come to pass, and so it's just kind of put my head in a tailspin. I kind of feel like I'm in the Twilight Zone, actually. It's the only way I can put it. And Matt's laughing because he knows. Are you drying your sweatshirt?
Yeah.
Wow. I'm not going to show him because he's not. He doesn't have his shirt on, and he would not be happy with me if I put him on here without his shirt. He'd be naked on the vlog, you guys. Naked. You can't let him be naked on the vlog. Look at. I got to turn. He's like. He's naked. No, he's naked. He's not naked.
You are entering the Twilight Zone.
Yeah, I really do. I feel like it's not something that I'm going to discuss because it's not my business to talk about. It's not. But, you know, sometimes in life, how do I say this? You know, I try to keep it really real on here, but there's some things that aren't my, it's not my place to share with you, I guess. You know, this isn't my business completely, but it is part of my external family. And so it's just kind of changing life up a bit, and I guess things are unexpected sometimes in life, I guess is the best way I can put it. And I'm sorry, I know I'm like being so evasive about things, but things can change in life that you just wouldn't expect. And for me right now, there's something going on in my external family that is so out of character for those family members. I mean, really out of character for those family members that I feel like I've entered the Twilight Zone. It's the best way to put it. So yeah, it's kind of had my head in a tailspin and kind of thrown things off. I don't know. It's affecting me. It's just affecting me, and it's going to take some getting used to. I don't know how to feel about the whole business. And there's been developments even since last night that have happened with this situation in my family that really made things unexpected for me. I mean, really made them unexpected for me. And I'm sorry, I can't share more because it really isn't my business to share. But when you're raised that things are a certain way, and I'm really open-minded, so it's not like, oh, my family raised me this way and this is how things are. But when you're raised by people and they always tell you things are a certain way, and then one day as you become an adult, they tell you that that's not how things are anymore. After almost 40 years, that's strange. And no, my parents aren't getting a divorce or something. So it's not that kind of thing. It's just, yeah, I can't tell you. I wish I could. But so that's what's going on. You know, this is daily vlog, and this is something going on in my personal life that's messing with my head. That's the best way I can put it. It's messing with my head. So my schedule is thrown off track because my head's been all messed up all day long. Ugh. Anyway, I'm going to get back on track and get back to reality and step out of the Twilight Zone and try to get this laundry done. All right, I am in the writing room, and yes, I have my coat on again. Oh, it's supposed to be in the 60s on Friday, so I'm excited for some warmer weather. But it gets chilly in this room. It gets chilly on this side of the house. And I picked up the camera because I'm actually answering some of your guys' comments. And you guys, I just love you. You have been leaving so many awesome comments, and I love going in and getting to them. I don't always get to respond to them right away. I usually try to come in once a day. I know I've missed a day or two, but I do go back and answer the questions. So if you leave a comment, don't feel like I'm ignoring your comment. I get in there and answer everyone's questions. And I try to respond back to every single comment that comes on our videos. So we love seeing the comments. It makes my day to see some of the things that you guys found exciting in the videos. So that's awesome. But the reason I picked up the camera is because I realized as I was answering some of the questions that I missed a couple of really like major things in our house that kind of would have been cool with the house story or the house tour story. So when I film tomorrow, because it's too dark tonight to show you guys those things, but when I film tomorrow, I'm going to try to remember to take and show you some of our house's coolest quirks, some of the things that really make this house unique and unusual. And then there's a couple of things that aren't unusual, but like the stained glass, which I didn't show you, and you may have seen it in some of the previous vlogs, but I want to show you our original stained glass because it is beautiful. And Tearlyn's room, you can't see it in as much, or you might not notice it as much, but she has a mirrored stained glass to what I have in this writing room. And I'm not going to show you tonight because you just can't see it it at night. You need to have that sunlight coming through to really, really appreciate how beautiful it is. But her red room just like pops with that stained glass. And this room I'm actually going to paint a color to bring out the color in that stained glass, because it looks really cool. And I think this room will end up having a black ceiling too, because it looks really neat with those deep jewel tone colors. Anyway, I'm gonna get back to answering comments. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow, guys.